संघर्ष ज्ञानहीन जन सलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे मनसा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावन वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरक्षिते गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै प्रधानय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय अङ्गश्यामलिं छटाभिरमितो मन्दिकचण्डीवरं जडं जावुदरोचि संविदधतं पटम्बरस्य वृन्दारण्यनिवासिनं हृदि लसद्दामाभिरामोदरं राधास्कन्दनिवेशितो जलभुजं ध्यायेन्दा श्री गुरु गौरांग राधा विनोद बिहारी जी की कृपा से आज सप्तम दिवस हम लोगों की ब्रजमंडल परिक्रमा समाप्त हुई, निर्विघ्न हुआ और आज लौ भवन रावल ब्रह्मांड घाट 84 खंभा जन्मस्थली और इसके बाद में दाऊ जी ये सब परिक्रमाएं हुई, वहां का महात्म भी आप लोगों ने सुना होगा। कल हमने बतलाया था भक्ति देवी स्वप्रकाश तत्व है, किंतु हमने ये भी कहा मध्यम भक्त की कृपा से भक्ति होती है। तो एक आदमी ने प्रश्न किया कि तो भक्ति स्वप्रकाशित कैसे रही, मध्यम भक्त ने दिया भक्ति कृपा करके, उसकी कृपा से होता है। तो हमने बतलाया था ध्यान नहीं दिया गया, भक्तों के हृदय में भक्ति है, इसलिए भक्ति भक्त्या संजायते, भक्ति से ही जो भक्तों के हृदय में है उसी भक्ति से ही, इसलिए इसमें कोई कंफ्यूजन नहीं। उसी को फिर बदला रहे हैं, भक्ति देवी स्वयं प्रकाशित हैं, किसी शुभ कर्म के द्वारा ये भक्ति नहीं हो सकती। माता पिता की सेवा, देश की सेवा, गरीबों की सेवा इससे नहीं, बल्कि पारमार्थिक सुकृति से भगवान भक्त औषधीय वस्तुओं के संपर्क में आने से जो सुकृति होता है उससे भक्तों का मिलन होता है, भक्तों का संग प्राप्त होता है और भक्तों के संग से ये भक्ति होती है। इसलिए जह केनापि अति भाग्येन जात श्रद्धो अस्य सेवने, श्रीमद्भागवत का यह श्लोक है। अर्थात जो व्यक्ति किसी अतिशय भाग्यवश भगवान की सेवा करने के लिए श्रद्धा युक्त होता है, इसी श्लोक में अतिशय भाग्येन शब्द का अर्थ वास्तविक अर्थ है शुभ कर्म जन्य भाग्य को अतिक्रमण करने वाले। शुभ कर्म के द्वारा नहीं होगा, किसी भगवत भक्त की कृपा, और वो भी भगवत भक्त उत्तम सिद्ध भागवतों की नहीं, भगवान की कृपा से भी नहीं। क्यों? भगवान सब समय आनंद रस में निमग्न रहते हैं, वो ये नहीं देखते हैं कि जीवों के को ये कष्ट होता है। जब किसी को कष्ट को देखते हैं तो चित्त द्रवित होता है, उस समय कृपा की आवश्यकता होती है, अन्यथा नहीं। भगवान तो रसिक है, रसलीला में रास इत्यादि में सब समय प्रवृत्त है, तो भक्त लोग उत्तम भक्त लोग भी सब समय भगवान की सेवा में नियुक्त रहते हैं, उनको ये फुर्सत नहीं है, देखते नहीं है कि इन लोगों को कष्ट है, वो देखता है कि प्राणी मात्र सभी भगवान की सेवा कर रहे हैं। प्रहलाद महाराज जी ने क्या कहा है शास्त्र में, यह सर्वोत्तम वो सब समय भगवत भाव का देखते हैं कि सभी लोग हमारे इष्ट देव को ही हमारे भाव से ही सेवा कर रहे हैं। इसलिए अब मध्यम भाग तो का है इसमें है, उनका अधिकार ही है चार, जिसमें बारिशों को मायावाद से रही जिज्ञासु हो, श्रद्धा हो, उनको ये भक्ति प्रदान कर, और उनमें भी जो भक्ति है उसी भक्ति के द्वारा ही वो करते। इसलिए यदि कहो कि भगवान ने प्रेरणा दी भक्तों के हृदय में, तब वो कृपा करते हैं, ऐसा भी नहीं करते। भगवान ने भक्तों को ये स्वतंत्रता दी है, मैं भक्तों का भक्तों के प्रति, और उन्हें कृपा करके वो अनुग्रह करने की शक्ति भक्तों में दे रखी है। कुछ कार्यों में उनका नियमन है, किंतु इस कार्य में उनका नियमन नहीं है, कंट्रोल नहीं है। यदि कहो ईश्वर की इच्छा और प्रेरणा के बिना भक्तों की कृपा स्वतंत्र रूप में कैसे उदित हो? भगवान किसी के हृदय में प्रेरणा करेंगे तब वो दूसरों को कृपा करेंगे, अतः भक्ति के कृपा के मूल में भी ईश्वर की प्रेरणा है, और तब वो भक्तों पर कृपा कर श्रद्धालुओं पर कृपा करते हैं। कहे नहीं, ऐसा मत सोचो। इस प्रश्न के उत्तर में चक्रपाल कहते हैं, भगवान ने स्वयं भक्त वश्यता के कारण भक्तों के हृदय में ऐसी कृपा शक्ति दे रखी है। भगवान के कुछ गुण भक्तों में संचरित होते हैं, तो ये गुण कृपा करने का भगवान ने उनके अंदर में दे रखा है कि भक्तों की कृपा ईश्वर की इच्छा या प्रेरणा की अपेक्षा नहीं रखती। भक्त स्वतंत्र रूप में जनसाधारण पर कृपा कर सकते हैं, भगवान ने स्वेच्छा पूर्वक अपने भक्तों को इस प्रकार उत्कर्ष का विधान किया, उन्होंने अधिकार दे रखा है। विशेषतः महत् कृपा, भक्तों की कृपा ऐसी स्वतंत्र नहीं होने से जगत में कोई भी भगवान की कृपा नहीं पा सकता था, संभव नहीं था। ये घर घर जाते हैं और अपने पूर्व जीवन का देखते हैं कि जगत में कितना दुख है और लोगों से मिलते जुलते हैं, इसलिए देखते हैं कि इनको इतना दुख है। जैसे स्वामी जी घर घर गए, श्रील प्रभुपाद भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर क्या किया, घर घर गए, किसी ने बुलाया नहीं, हम दुखी हैं आइए हमको हमारी सहायता कीजिए, भक्ति कीजिए, बल्कि स्वयं कृपा बरसता है। भक्तों की कृपा ऐसी स्वतंत्र नहीं होने से जगत में भगवत प्राप्त करना किसी के लिए महादुर्लभ होता। भगवान परिपूर्ण आनंद खन अपाप विद्ध माया स्वस्थ रहित है, जीव से यही इनकी विशेषता है। जैसे सूर्य में तनिक अंधकार रहने की कोई संभावना नहीं है, जो जगत को प्रकाशित करते हैं, दीप के नीचे अंधकार हो सकता है किंतु सूरज के कहीं भी अंधकार रहने की संभावना नहीं है। उसी प्रकार परिपूर्ण सुख स्वरूप भगवान में दुख का स्पर्श नहीं है। श्रुति कहती है आदित्य वर्ण तमसा परस्ता, इसलिए जीव का कोई भी दुख भगवान को स्पर्श नहीं कर सकता। जो पहले बतला जीव दुखी है उनको ये स्पर्श नहीं कर सकता, और यदि स्पर्श करता तो दयालुता आती, कृपा आती, इसलिए जीवों के प्रति उनकी ऐसी नहीं है। वे आनंद भंग स्वरूप होने के कारण अपने स्वयं के आनंद में भी बहुत रहते हैं, और यह भी बात ठीक है दूसरों के दुख का चित्त में स्पर्श होने पर ही कृपा होती है, अन्यथा कृपा नहीं होती। परमानंद खनिज श्री भगवान में पूर्ण शक्ति रहने पर भी बहुरूप जीवों के प्रति उनकी करुणा सर्वथा असंभव है। इसलिए पतित और दुखी जीवों के उद्धार के लिए एकमात्र स्वतंत्र महत्वता ही उपाय है। और भी प्रश्न हो सकता है, अंतर्यामी भगवान अंतर्यामी रूपी से समस्त जीवों के हृदय में प्रेरणा या अंतर इंद्रियों में बाहरी इंद्रियों में क्रिया शक्ति क्यों देते हैं? इसी के लिए कहा गया ईश्वर सर्वभूतानां हृदये से अर्जुन तिष्ठति भ्रामयन् सर्वभूतानि जन्तुर्ग्राहाणि मायया। अंतर्यामी भगवान सब जीवों के अंतर में विराज रह करके उनको विविध कर्मों में प्रवृत्त कराकर उनके कर्मों के अनुसार और जंत्र आरूढ़ की भांति उनको परिचालित करते हैं। तो क्या भक्तों के भी हृदय में ऐसे ही नियंत्रण करते हैं? नहीं, भक्तों के लिए नहीं। भगवान स्वयं कहते हैं तत्प्रसादात् परां शांतिं स्थानं प्राप्ति प्रसाद, मेरी कृपा से ही मेरे भक्तगण मुझ में फली भांति स्थित जो पराशक्ति है उसे प्राप्त करते हैं। यहां प्रसाद से भगवान की कृपा को ही समझना चाहिए। इसलिए अंत में यही सिद्ध हुआ भक्ति स्वप्रकाश है। मध्यम भक्तों के हृदय में जो भक्ति है उसी भक्ति के द्वारा दूसरों को वो भक्ति प्रदान करते हैं। इसलिए भक्ति की स्वप्रकाशता का कोई भी खंडन नहीं किया जा सकता। वो ठीक है लीजिए।
छंदाय नारिकाय निदाले कृष्णाय कृष्णवाक्ताय तदवाक्ताय नमो नमः.
Therefore, one question was raised that yesterday we heard that bhakti is swaprakash, self-illuminating and independent. But yesterday we also heard that bhakti is dependent on the mercy of Madhyamadika. So maybe there is contradiction. Sugriva said that person who wrote the question was not giving so much attention. Therefore, yesterday we discussed that bhakti is present in the heart of the Madhyamadika. So because he has that bhakti already, then he is giving it. Therefore, bhakti is not dependent on any other thing, because it's already present there. Yesterday we heard that bhakti cannot be attained by an accumulation of supakarma, punya, means pious materialistic activities, like serving one's mother or father, or serving the country, or serving the sick persons. Bhakti will not arise by the such punya sukriti. Neither will bhakti arise by a lack of such super sukriti. Therefore, bhakti arises how? By nitya sukriti, or some service performed with knowledge or without knowledge to Bhagavan or Bhagavan's tadya vastu, that which is related to Bhagavan, some connection with Bhagavan or Bhagavan's own objects. By that nitya sukriti or bhakti sukriti, one can get the chance to attain sadhu sangha, and by that sadhu sangha one can achieve bhakti, and by that bhakti one can meet Bhagavan. Therefore, bhakti is only achieved by the mercy of devotee. And yesterday we heard also, bhakti is not achieved by the mercy of Bhagavan, nor is bhakti only achieved by the mercy of Uttam Bhagavat, the Vaishnava on the highest platform of bhakti. Then why bhakti is not achieved by the mercy of Krishna? Because Krishna is always drowning in the nectar of Rajaras, Anandaras. Therefore, he is so full of happiness, he is not even aware of the suffering of the jiva. But if somehow he can become aware of it, then he gives his mercy. The Uttam Vaishnava is in a similar situation. He is always completely absorbed in the Nitya Lila of Radha Krishna. Therefore, he never sees anything nor hears anything. Therefore, he cannot understand that jivas in this world are suffering. Because he sees, like Prahlad Maharaj, Sarva Bhutasya Yapasat Bhagavan Bhavam Atmana. He sees all are liberated, all are serving Krishna according to his own mood. Therefore, the Uttam Bhagavat Vaishnava can have no experience that jivas are suffering in this world. Therefore, Madhyamadikari sees these things. Therefore, bhakti is achieved by his association. But to whom will the Madhyamadika give mercy to? That disciple, we say, should be free from Mayavad. He should be Jigyasa, meaning he should be, or he or she should be eager to inquire, and they must have faith to follow the instructions received. When Madhyamadika sees that type of disciple, then bhakti is given. Therefore, Bhagavan is, even though we say he is independent, Bhagavan is also not independent. Aham bhakta paradino. He admits, I am controlled by my devotee. Therefore, Krishna himself does not deliver anyone. Krishna empowers his devotee to deliver the jivas of this world. Then some say, if Bhagavan is independent, then he empowers the devotee. So that answer is given by Sri Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. No question of empowering, because the qualities of Bhagavan are automatically present in the devotee. No question of giving. Everything is there already in the devotee. Therefore, Bhagavan is dependent and the mercy of the devotee is also independent. Therefore, in this world, those who are acting on the platform of Madhyamadika, like our Bhaktivan Swami Maharaj, or Thakur Bhaktivinoda Thakur, their mercy is independent because no one is inviting them. Oh Maharaj, suffering too much, come and deliver me. No. Out of their own violation, out of their own mercy, out of their own independence, they are moving house to house to relieve the sufferings of those jivas. Therefore, such a chance to achieve that association is very rare. Therefore, the devotee is also independent in giving his mercy. Another example of how Bhagavan is unaware, in one sense, of the suffering of the jivas. Just like the sun, there is no touch of darkness in the sun. If we say there is a lamp, a ghee lamp, there is some darkness under the ghee lamp. But that example cannot be given according to Krishna. He is completely transcendental. Therefore, the sufferings of the jivas in this world cannot even touch him in the slightest. And if somehow he allows himself to be touched to understand the suffering of the jivas, then he will give mercy, otherwise he cannot. Therefore, the Upanishads describe that Bhagavan is neutral in one sense. As Paramatma, he is present in everyone's heart, but he is little nirapex, little neutral position. But the bhakta of Bhagavan is not completely like this. Therefore, the conclusion is, means he sees the suffering in when he comes to Madhyamanika. Therefore, the conclusion is, bhakti is swaprakash, bhakti is not dependent on anything else, bhakti is self-illuminating. The Madhyamanika, because that bhakti is present in his heart, therefore he is also not dependent on anything else, he is dependent only on that bhakti. Therefore, because he has that swaprakash bhakti in himself, therefore he has the ability to give to others. There should be no doubts in this.
Discussed about the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What are the special kripa?
ज्ञानांजनशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः स्वदैतनिजभावं यो विभाव्य स्वभावात् सुमधुरवतीर्णो भक्तरूपेण लोभात् जयति कनकधामा कृष्णचैतन्यनामा हरिहयतिवेशा श्रीसचिसूनुरेशा सो श्री गुरुदेव हैज ऑर्डर्ड मी टू गिव द टीचिंग्स ऑफ चैतन्य महाप्रभु टू एक्सप्लेन द टीचिंग्स ऑफ चैतन्य महाप्रभु So by the mercy of Gurudev, I'll speak something about the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which I am also trying to understand and practice in my life. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has told, especially, first verse of Shikshashtaka, Cheto Darpana Marjanam Bhava Mahadavagni Nirvapanam Shreya Kairava Chandrika Vitaranam Vidyavadu Jeevanam आनंदांगुली वर्धनम प्रतिपदम पूर्णामृतास्वादनम सर्वात्म स्वपनम परम विजयते श्रीकृष्ण संकीर्तनम दैट दिस श्रीकृष्ण संकीर्तन इज वेरी ब्लिसफुल इट इज लाइक अ शावर ऑफ नेक्टर एंड ऑफ द हार्ट ऑफ द लिविंग एंटिटीज हु आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम थ्रीफोल्ड मिजरी आदिदैविक आध्यात्मिक आदिभौतिक क्लेशस एंड इग्नोरेंस in their heart is dissipated by the shower of the nectar. So this Harinam is actually the Vidyavatu Jivanam. The living entities, all distress comes from avidya. And this avidya is destroyed by Nam Prabhu. Because Nam Prabhu's bride is actually Vidya. That is Paravidya, the transcendental knowledge. By chanting the Harinam, the transcendental knowledge appears in the heart of the living entities, and when their avidya is destroyed, they feel blissful. However, every living entity has Swarup Brahm as to who I am. So therefore Mahaprabhu told that you should know that all of you are servants of Krishna. All of you are eternal servants of Krishna. He said, Naham Parni Nacha Narapatir Rastho Yatirva Kintu Pratyam Nikhila Paramananda Purna Mrutabde Gopi Bhartru Padakamala Yor Dasa Dasa Dasa. That I don't come under any social classification or any spiritual classification. I don't come under any type of classification based on country, creed, caste or anything. But I am eternally servant of Krishna. My worshipable deity, he is, all our worshipable deity is Brajendra Nandan Shri Krishna. Aradhyo Bhagavan Brajashatanayas Tat Dhamma Vrindavanam. Ramya Kachid Upasana Brajavadhu Vargena Yakalpita Srimad Bhagavatam Pramana Mamalam Prema Puvartho Mahan Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matavidam Tatra Darona Parat. Shri Chakravarti Pat Thakur says that Aradhyo Bhagavan Brajashatanayas, that our worshipable deity is Brajendra Nandan Shyama Sundar Krishna, who has Srimati Radhika on his left hand side, his Swarupa Shakti. And his Vrindavan Dham is also as worshipable as Sri Krishna. This Vrindavan Dham is not different from Sri Krishna. Because this Vrindavan Dham is always reverberating with the flute song of Sri Krishna. And therefore when Mahaprabhu came here, he also found that this Vrindavan Dham, which is fragrant by the parakkad, by the pollen from the lotuses in the Jamuna, he found very charming, and everywhere he had spurti of Krishna. Mukunda Murali Rama Shravana Kulla Rut Vallavi Kadambaka Karambita Prati Kadamba Kunjantara Kalintagini Nandini Kamala Kandalan Dolina Sugandhi Ravinenebe Sharanamastu Vrindadavi. So Mahaprabhu has advised us to always take shelter of Sri Vrindavan Dham. And now what is the proof for this? Mahaprabhu has said, Srimad Bhagavatam. The first canto, second canto, especially the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, and 11th canto and 12th canto, these are actually the evidence for whatever we follow. Srimad Bhagavatam is actually the essence of all the Vedas. Nigama Kalpa Taror Galitam Palam Shukamukhat Amrita Drava Samyutam Vibata Bhagavatam Rasamalayam Murava Rasika Bhuvi Bhau. So, Mahaprabhu has told that Srimad Bhagavatam. So, especially chanting of the holy name, Mahaprabhu's greatest contribution, because without chanting the holy name, the living entities cannot advance. So therefore, Mahaprabhu gave the pranali, siddha pranali.
Aradhana is based. Huh? We have left what aradhana is based.
And aradhana also, Srila Gurudev is telling me that what, how to perform the aradhana of Sri Krishna. Aradhana Vraja Vargena Ya Kalpita. Vrajavadhu Vargena Ya Kalpita. Vrajavadhus, especially gopis. Among the all the devotees of Sri Krishna, the gopis are the highest. Because Sri Krishna himself has told that Na Pareham Viravatya Samyujan Sadhukrityam Vibhudari Shabya Yama Bhajan Durjar Geha Shrunkala Samrashya Yate Paryati Sadhuna. Krishna has not said so about any of his devotees. He told, however, the gopis that I cannot repay you. You have completely indebted me. And everyone from the women in the city of Hastinapur, who are the subjects of Yudhishthir Maharaj, Bhishma Pitamaha, who is actually a warrior, Kunti Devi, and even Maheshis of Dwarka and Shri Uddhav, has glorified the gopis. So the gopis worship is the highest. And among them, Radhika's worship is the highest. And therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come in this world to relish the food of Srimati Radhika. And he has relished it as confirmed by Srila Sanatana Goswami in Brihat Bhagavatamritam. Sva Daitanija Bhavavya Vibhavya Svabhavat. Sumadhuravatirna Bhakta Rupena Lobha Jayati Kanaka Dhamma Krishna Chaitanya Nama Haririha Yati Vesha Sri Sachi Sudresha. Srimati Radhika is his Daita. Daita means one who serves him by her deha, by her body, mind and soul. She is continuously serving him and very beloved of Sri Krishna, very life of Sri Krishna. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu understood her mood, especially her Madanakya Mahabhava. And he relished it. And he accepted the name Krishna Chaitanya. And he gave up his abode of Navadvip and became a sannyasi in order to take teachings from Swarup Damodar and Raya Ramananda. So therefore, this worship of the gopis is the highest, and Mahaprabhu himself has taught us that one should execute this Raga Marga Bhakti. Some people say that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to this world only to give Naam Sankirtan. This is not true, because Bhagavan Krishna has said, Yada yada hi dharmasya glade bhavati bharata apyutthanam adharmasya tadatmanam surjamyam paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha dushkrutam dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. The removing irreligion and establishing religion, these activities are done by the Narayan, the Yugavatar, which is in the body of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu. The Gaura Narayan marries Vishnu Priya and Lakshmi Priya, and he gives the process of Nama Sankirtan for delivering the living entities. However, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, who is actually Radha Bhava Dhyuti Savrita, is the combined form of Radha Krishna, or Radha Krishna, who has accepted the mood and complexion of Radhika. He actually only relishes the mood of Radhika. He only tries to understand the glories of Radhika, and he tries to preach the Raga Marga Bhakti. So the greatest contribution of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the primary reason he came to this world, is that he wanted to test the mood of Radhika, and another primary reason is that he wanted to preach the Raga Marga Bhakti, the bhakti in the mood of the gopis to the entire world. However, as secondary consequence, as a secondary contribution to the world, he also alongside preached Nama Sankirtan. So Nama Sankirtan is the primary means for the jivas, the conditioned jivas, in order to rise to the platform of Raga Marga Bhakti. However, one should also associate with the Rasika Vaishnavas as our Srila Gurudev. And as we see that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's biggest contribution to this world was Rupa Goswami. Priya Swarupe, Daita Swarupe, Prema Swarupe, Sahajag Rupe, Prabhu Rekha Rupe, Tatal Rupe, Savilas Rupe. That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is the sentiment of his heart, one drop of the love. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is an ocean of love, and that one drop of that love appeared in the heart of Rupa Goswami, and Rupa Goswami distributed that love to the entire world through his books such as Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Ujjala Nilamani, and so on. So Srila Gurudev, as a representative of Srila Rupa Goswami, is the real mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu for the entire world. And without the mercy of Srila Gurudev, we can never understand the contribution of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or Nityananda Prabhu. So the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, Srila Gurudev has told me to speak about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy. I feel that Srila Gurudev is the embodiment of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy. Vidai Gaur Premanand.
So one question has come to Srila Gurudev from a person in the audience regarding the subject that Srila Gurudev is speaking this evening about, the independent nature of bhakti. There is a doubt that he is expressing here, saying, then can we say that bhakti is dependent on shraddha or on dependent upon greed, lobha? So this is the question. Is bhakti dependent on
shraddha? You should know what is shraddha. This is the beginning of bhakti, part of bhakti. So shraddha and bhakti is empty. Last stage. So bhakti begins from there. So no question of bhakti is dependent of shraddha.
Another question. Is the Madhyam Adhikari is the Madhyam Adhikar and Uttam Adhikari that comes down to the Madhyam level to give bhakti, or is it that a Madhyam Adhikari only who has received bhakti and therefore can transmit it? So his question is the Madhyam Adhikari who can give bhakti, is he coming down from the Uttam platform, or is it an actual Madhyam Adhikari who's coming up, Kanishtha, then Madhyam, that he can give bhakti? He can transmit bhakti.
This is the same thing. A sadhak bhakta, first he will be Kanishtha Adhikari. And gradually by the mercy of Madhyam Adhikari, Kanishtha comes in Madhyam. Then he becomes Madhyam Adhikari, and then he does kripa to all. Or like Narada Rishi and others, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur Goswami, all were Uttam Adhikari Mahabhagavat, but they had descent in Madhyam Adhikar, and then they had sprinkled their mercy to Sadhalu, Avgyani, there. So this is the same thing.
So, you have described many times that there are different levels of Kanishtha, different levels of Madhyam, and also different levels of Uttam. So, you have also described that in order to become Guru, the devotee should be at least in the Madhyam stage. So is this true, that only in the middle stage of Madhyam Adhikari that he now has the qualification to become Guru and to give?
I have told before, though he is in middle, Madhya, or Uttam Madhya, both mean, I think it would be better, more qualified Madhyam Adhikari when he is Uttam Madhyam Adhikari. He can sprinkle his mercy to all. Can you speak something about the mercy of Mahaprabhu?
And teachings of Śrī Caitanya Mahāprabhu. Śrīla Gurudeva himself has explained that in order to understand Śrī Caitanya Mahāprabhu's teachings, we have to take shelter of Śrīla Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Otherwise it's not possible. Namo Bhakti Vinodaya Satchidānanda Nāmine Gaura Shakti Sarupaya Rupānu Gavarayate. Śrīla Bhaktivinoda Thakur, especially, he's explained the teachings and mercy of Śrī Caitanya Mahāprabhu in two ways. In one way, he's given his commentary on Śrī Śikṣāṣṭakam. especially in his Bhajana Hasya, he has gone so deeply explaining the significance of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's 8 prayers, how he is explaining the development from Shraddha, from chanting in the association of devotees, right up to praying. And he has explained the gradual development not only of the different stages of the development of praying, but also he's explained the connection between the pairs of names in a Hare Krishna Maha Mantra and these stages of praying. Also in the different stages of Ashtakalya Leela. So in this way, he's explained how a sadhak begins chanting Cheto Darpanam Arjanam Baba Mahana Davagni Devarpanam. Then Nam Namakari Bhavadan Nijisarva Shaktis. In the first verse, Cheto Darpanam Arjanam, he's giving an overview of the whole development. And then in the successive verses, then Nam Namakari Bhavadan Nijisarva Shaktis. How devotee has faith in the chanting of the holy name, how he develops humility. And in the last chapter of Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself tastes this gradual progression from faith in chanting up to the mood of Srimati Radhika, Ashlishiva Padar Tangpanastumam, that I don't care whether Krishna gives me his darshan, or he may even enjoy with somebody else in front of me. If he wants to enjoy with another gopi, then I will personally bring that gopi to Krishna. So this mood of, this is the limit of service, mood of service to Krishna without desire for personal enjoyment. So in this way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu tasted these moods, and Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he has explained this progression. Then, he has also explained in Dashamula Tattva, the different aspects of Tattva, how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Tattva that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given, Amnaya Praha Tattva. First of all, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is emphasizing that we have to accept the authority of the Vedic scriptures. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his followers, Goswamis, especially Srila Jeev Goswami, they've established that all other forms of evidence are useless without the Vedic scriptures. Evidence such as pratyaksha, the evidence of the senses, this is useful insofar as it's following the Vedic scriptures. Otherwise it's useless. So what does this Vedic, what do the Vedic scriptures establish? First of all, that Krishna, Hari, he is the Supreme Personality, he is the Supreme Absolute Truth. Everything rests within him. He is the origin of everything. And in the end, everything goes into him. Sarva Shakti, he has all energies. Internal energies, external energy, marginal energy. All of this is his, the action of his spiritual energy, and ultimately Radhika is Purna Shakti, Krishna Purna Shakti Man. Ultimately, this depends on Srimati Radhika as the energy of Krishna. Then Rasabdi, he is also the ocean of Ras. Then that the Jivas, their Vipinamsha, their expansion, the separated expansions of Krishna. Vishnu Tattva is Krishna himself, different manifestations of Krishna, according to, just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nam Namakari Bhavanaji Nijasarva Shaktis. All the names of Krishna, they have Shakti according to the form of that name, according to that Namni. So for example, if we chant the name of Raha, this will give one result. If we chant the name of Narayan, this will give another result. If we chant the name of Vrajendranandan Krishna, this will give another result. So therefore, for example, Srila Gurudev is emphasizing that we should chant Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya. These names when Krishna is performing pastimes with Srimati Radhika, with gopis, and especially with Srimati Radhika, these names are particularly powerful. That the jivas, they are either subject to Maya or they're liberated from Maya. Then, Beda Bedam Prakasham, everything, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given this perfect summary of all the Vedic teachings. Our Vaishnava Acharyas, they have given Vastu Parinamba. The previous Acharyas, they've given Vastu Parinamba. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he's explained Shakti Parinamba. This is Achinja Beda Beda Tattva. This is the perfect synthesis of all the teachings, that Krishna is none different from his energies, and everything that we see is a transformation of his energy. It's not a transformation of Krishna himself. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has emphasized that the sadhan is Shuddha Bhakti and nothing else. When, for example, he met with the Tattvavadis, so he paused, because the Tattvavadis are very proud, as they're thinking that they're very great Vaishnavas. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is coming shaved like Mayavadi Sannyasi. So he presented himself very humbly. So what is the perfection of life? So they said that, the leader of the Tattvavadi said that, we should perform our duties in Varanashram and offer the results to Krishna. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, I think you're cheating me. And then he established that actually, Prema Pumarto Maha, this is the fifth necessity, and this overrides everything else. And the process of attaining prem, this is Shuddha Bhakti. And this is that the actual goal of human existence, this is prem. What kind of prem? So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he's come to taste Braj prem. Not only Braj prem in general, but specifically the prem of the gopis, and specifically Srimati Radhika. And also to distribute Ragma Bhakti Loke, Prachara. So he's come both to taste it and to distribute it. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he's kindly come to both to taste the very high, the inconceivable mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is that he comes in Kali Yuga, when the jivas are in such a fallen condition, and only in this time is this high service available. Only this incarnation, only this form of Krishna gives us a bhakti shri. Not the sabhakti. Sabhakti means the bhakti of Srimati Radhika. But the bhakti of the assistance to Srimati Radhika, this is only available through Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his followers, and no one else. So this is the inconceivable mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that only at this time, in Kali Yuga, is this very highest possible service. Even higher, Srila Rupa Goswami and other acharyas, they've explained that the service of the mandris to Srimati Radhika is even higher than the service of Lalita Vishaka and so on, because they're closer to Srimati Radhika. They can perform services to Srimati Radhika that she will not ask Lalita Vishaka to perform. And also, they can come and serve the divine couple at a time when no one else can come to serve them. So although the Ashtasakhi and other devotees there, other expansions, they are senior, but the most fortunate of the mandris. And this service, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to give at this time. But this is available not through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, but through the Acharyas and his Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya. So, we're very fortunate that our Acharyas have successively revealed this. And we're especially fortunate that our beloved Gurudev, he is publicly revealing this. My Guru Maharaj went from place to place in the West, and he presented Krishna consciousness in such a way that even he himself said, people in the West, they're living like animals. But he made a presentation of Krishna consciousness which could engage even such animal-like personalities like myself, mad, completely mad with desire for sense gratification and frustration. and coming after him, our beloved Gurudev has revealed the innermost mood to Srila Jiva Goswami, Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. He has said himself that he's like Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. He can't help revealing everything. And he said, this is my mood also. And when he was commenting on Srila Vilapa Kusumanjali. So we're so fortunate that our beloved Srila Gurudev, he's actually enabling us to begin to, he's giving not Raganuga Bhakti immediately, but Raganuga Pravritti Vaidhi Bhakti, even with such fallen personalities as ourselves. And who can understand? He's taken the risk of being thoroughly condemned in our Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya, because very, very few Gaudiya Vaishnavas even can understand the moods and intentions and teachings of our beloved Gurudev. So, with this I'll invite Sweet Varsha Kalkakru Desha, Kumbhavari Desha, Kumbhavari Desha,
I am very happy that Western devotees also, they know all these things, very, very deep things, but how all are knowing. Bhaktivedanta Prapujya Charan, Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj has preached and written in his books everything. But he never preached like this, to know all these things. So you are very, very lucky to know all these very, very deep things. Thank you. एक प्रश्न आया है, क्या भगवान की इच्छा नहीं रहने पर भी किसी को भक्ति प्राप्त होने का उदाहरण है? भगवान की कृपा नहीं होने से भी, भगवान की इच्छा नहीं होने पर भी किसी को भक्ति प्राप्त होने का उदाहरण है? यह प्रश्न गलत है। जैसे भगवान यदि मर जाए तो क्या होगा? भगवान मर जाएगा, भगवान मरेगा कभी? भगवान की जरूर इच्छा रहेगी ही, ऐसा कभी भी नहीं होगा कि भगवान की इच्छा नहीं है। इसलिए गोलोक धाम से वृंदावन उतरते हैं, जितने अवतार लेते हैं सब किस लिए? सबको अपने में मिलाने के लिए, अपनी भक्ति को प्रचार करने के लिए। इसलिए ये ठीक नहीं। बहुत
So there's a couple of more questions that are coming here for Srila Gurudev. The bhakti that is in the heart of a madhyam sadhaka, is this the same as the bhakti that is in the heart of a uttam mahabhagwat who has come down to the madhyam platform? In other words, a bhakta who is a sadhaka, he has gradually attained the stage of madhyam. The bhakti that is in his heart, is it the same bhakti that is in the heart of a uttam bhagavat who comes down?
Bhakti is same, but stages are different. In uttam adhikari, the stage of bhakti is so high, he will tell, oh, bhakti should come. But Madhyam Adhikari cannot do like this. These are some different.
But that Uttam Adhikari who gives this blessing, that bhakti will come immediately,
now
is he?
Yeah. At once, Gopi Bhav should come. Madhyam Adhikari cannot do.
But when this Uttam Adhikari gives this blessing, is he acting in Madhyam stage at that time?
Kindly he accepts that. But really he is not
Madhyam.
Madhyama Adhikaya part. Never his Madhyama Adhikaya, Uttama Adhikaya, but he plays like
Another question?
Yes, one more question. Which level of bhakta, which level of the devotee is capable to give the seed of Palyadasi Bhav? In other words, if a devotee is in madhyam level, like sadhaka, is he able to give this Palyadasi Bhav? Or must he first...
If Madhyam had achieved Shuddha Sattva,
Jatarati.
And by mind he is vasati, meditating and serving, he can be.
Then what he will be higher, such bhakta, such sadhaka, he will be higher level than Madhyam. Maybe he will be Uttam Madhyam then.
Uttam Madhyam, I told him already.
Yes.
Or if Maharani Janaki ji prashna kar rahi hai, Janakpur ki Maharani Ajodhya ki Janaki ji, Madhyam Adhikari bhakti dene mein samarth hai, kis prakar ki? Sab prakar ki. यदि मध्यम अधिकारी रूप गोस्वामी के अनुगत होकर के भजन करते करते वो राधा जी की पाल्य दासी होने की भावना रख करके करता है तो वह तक नहीं है, कोई भी बाधा नहीं है। क्या वे भक्ति की सर्वोच्च अवस्था तक पहुंचा सकते हैं? वो पहुंचा रास्ता बदला देंगे, क्योंकि अभी तक वो सर्वोच्च अवस्था में नहीं गए। हम यहीं से बतला देंगे कि यहां से हरिद्वार जाओ, हरिद्वार से बद्री नारायण होते हुए चले जाओ, ऊपर चले जाओ, किंतु तुमको पकड़ करके ले जाएंगे नहीं, बतला देंगे, चलना पड़ेगा। इसलिए रास्ता बतला देंगे, चलना पड़ेगा। गौर प्रेमानंद तुम्हारो कल हम लोग कहाँ कहाँ जाएंगे? श्रमी
बंसीवट
गोपेश्वर महादेव लाल गोविंद जी का
गोविंद देव
तुम्हारो यू विल विजिट श्री दर्शन टेक दर्शन ऑफ ही श्रमिक एंड बंसीवट गोपेश्वर महादेव देन कमिंग
गोविंद
देव एंड कमिंग
हरे कृष्ण
हरि बोल हरे कृष्ण। All of you are really relishing the nectar of the Hari Katha here. You can have a permanent record of the nectar of the Hari Katha by going to the back of the room and getting the DVD sets that have been arranged by Isha, who works tirelessly to collect all of the lectures of Srila Gurudev. So please get a chance to take a permanent record of these Hari Katha home, so you can constantly see Srila Gurudev and hear the Hari Katha on the DVDs. Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna, Sadananda Prabhu and Vrindavan Chandra from Amritsar. Please meet me. Sadananda Prabhu or Vrindavan Chandra Prabhu, Amritsar wale, kripya mere se sampark kare. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.